Chief and Star presents.
Yep, it's the Chief, and today I want to discuss why Marvel vs. Capcom should reboot the entire series. Hear me out. And this comes at the most perfect time since Bob Iger, the most deplorable man to run Disney, has stated he wants to go back to what the investors and true fans want, which seriously pisses me off because it's 2024, 2K24, why didn't y'all do this in the first place? Especially since y'all have lost 95% of your core audience while losing billions of dollars. Anyway, this fits perfect because everyone is obsessed with the multiverse. And if you catch my drift, yes, this game will basically use the same excuse to reboot everything. I mean, hey, everyone's doing it, but they didn't have actual Marvel characters for it to be popular enough or even make sense. Yeah. The thing is, I was against this until I thought about it, and then my creative genius kicked in and wouldn't let me sleep, like, at all. Do y'all remember, like, that crossover art series that this Japanese artist did for MVC in, like, I want to say 2012? Well, those pictures went viral and everyone said they wished they had some kind of event to make it happen. Ryu is literally wearing Cyclops' fit, and my god, is he dripped the F out. Now that we have Disney claiming to be fixing the in-house problems, maybe we can get the game the FGC and mainstream truly deserve. The first thing we gotta do first is delete NVCI, totally. Like, that universe didn't happen, it never existed. Ryu was not a mother effing scientist. Where did he even get his degree from? Bro doesn't even own shoes. Alright, I'll say take some of the characters out in NVCI, bring them over, but the main roster should be NVC2, then add the extras from 3, and yada yada, etc, 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 etc. This game should be a legacy of heroes, not some dry spell of an ethot chaser. We gotta think big, and this game shouldn't have character restrictions, Disney and Capcom. Oh. Wait, I thought I was gonna let Capcom slide?
Hell nah.
I mean, there are literal rumors from 4 years ago that Capcom's on the verge of losing legacy IPs to a billion-dollar company. Yeah. Either sink or swim, Blue Giant. You need to have older, way older IPs in here. I'm talking Cannon Spike, I'm talking Rival Schools, Power Stone, even games that failed the legendary and most hated of all time, Capcom test. Or don't bother making it. Period. The reason why is that if the character is dope, people will say, who the F is that? What game they come from? Then there is a door to reboot that series.
It's free real estate.
I mean, y'all gotta add Dragon's Dogma in here, which I think is the funniest thing ever, because who do you even add from Dragon's Dogma to represent the game? The fighter? I think the fighter would be the best one. I'm also resigning one of my certain statements because I think gag characters should be included, but make them actually fight somehow. And also add them as a DLC pack down the line, like after the game sells millions and millions and millions of copies. Another thing I'll fight everyone about is characters should have classic costumes and unique redesigns, which means there's gonna be fan service. Yes, fan service. Go ahead and cry about it now, I don't care. I want problems always. Also, before y'all say I'm an incel, I'm top 0.1% on all dating apps, and yes, I do get approached. Roll the clip. I mean, type shit. She-Hulk gonna have her skin tight fit, and I'm talking the OG one, fam. Classic Marvel, like 90s when she was like slim thick, you feel me? And so will the rest of them. If you got beef, square up. Square the F up, cause I'm tired of y'all being scared of women's bodies, dog. Grow up. I mean, I can literally go on Twitter right now and see women built like a Coke bottle, BBL, spreading her raw butt cheeks for $5.99 on OF. But God forbid, a female video game character be sexy. Get the F out, y'all are weird. The best part of this is the crossover costumes, which I can only imagine makes this game a day one buy. Like, can you imagine Mega Man wearing a Captain America fit? Imagine Felicia rocking the Jill Valentine costume from the classic Resident Evil. This kind of multiverse experience paired up with Marvel would be the best-selling fighter of the year, maybe of all time. But we do have another battleground topic, and I know a lot of y'all are gonna be mad, and you're gonna debate in the comments. I can feel the anger from some of y'all already. I can feel it just bubbling up. But They need arc system works, not want, they need them. In fact, I heard a rumor like around 2020 that Disney was like, unless they make the graphics and visuals similar in a continuation, it wasn't gonna fly. Especially after MVCI got buried by Dragon Ball FighterZ, it was done. It was over. It was so jover. People were pissed at Marvel. They were like, what in the F is happening? Yeah. People said I was crazy. But the proof was them dropping the game completely and acting like MVCI never even happened. They erased everything, dog. Besides the trailers you see, you will not see anything else ever come out, period. Capcom went with RE Engine and Disney went with the live service games, which didn't do well at all, like Avengers and Guardians of the Galaxy, which flopped, of course. My opinion is Capcom should bend the knee. Y'all done made so much money, and if y'all just let Arc System Works bless this reboot with their gift, it will go crazy, you feel me? I personally might cry, because the graphics would modernize the best one of the series, in my opinion, NVC2. I mean, come on. We've already done classic 2D, 90s, associated 3D, or 2000s, hyper-realistic 3D, 2016. The only option is the true D, aka 2.5D. I'm just not arguing with anybody on this anymore. We're just gonna have to agree, disagree, honestly. Just let it happen. Like, why are y'all so against something that fits NVC as a series in the first place? I also see there are folks generally mad at the way Dragon Ball Sparking looks, and that's the best that the games looked. Like, y'all's minds are absolutely fried. If you want real life, go outside. I promise you, no one's stopping you. Like, I'm so tired of this. Everything has to look like a real life aesthetic. It was cool in 2016, now it's gone overboard and is severely, I mean severely oversaturated. It'll get to the point where like, it's literally like outside. What's the point, dog? What is the point? The next thing is a story, and I already have the concept down to a science. Now listen up. The teaser trailer would show Mega Man Zero running from something, but you can't see who or what it is. The game footage would be from Game Boy Advance, basically the first Mega Man Zero series game, so it's like 2000s 2D, and the screen on the left is getting dark and green.
If you know, you know.
As he gets to the end, he's holding his arm as he's damaged and breaks through a door. He jumps down a tunnel falling down, and as he does, he goes through shadows. This is where you gotta pay attention, y'all. Pay attention. There are three shadows, and they change his art style from MVC2 to MVC3 to MVCI in that exact order, but he then breaks through a portal while falling and lands in a grassy open field. This is hinting to other universes as Mega Man Zero stands up and he is now in a unique comic-like true D 2.5D arc system style and is looking around his surroundings. In my head, I just like see Maximilian Dude literally punching his chair and throwing it in a fit of hype violent rage. So yeah. Then I feel like I'd hear grown men and women crying around the world. Legit, like, ugly crying. Mega Man Zero then rushes to the screen, breaking the fourth wall, and asks the audience for help, stating, and I quote, "I don't think I'll make it out alive, but if you could please send the rest this message." Mega Man Zero then takes out his Z-Saber, cuts a symbol in the screen that literally is a 4, before the entity grabs a hold of him, and the 4 then turns into a ball of light, shattering, showing the multiverse similar to the comics in the MCU. I've had a little dream about that, and when I tell you, I woke up confused and hyped at the same damn time. Then for the actual debut trailer, this one is absolutely bonkers. Strap in. So right off the bat, we're in New York City, Spider-Man's home. Destroyed, there's rubble everywhere, destruction all around. But we do see a familiar face fighting some enemies. This turns out to be Ryu, younger, unique costume, as he is fighting other heroes, but something is off. They have different outfits, and this is where a large majority of the community's PTSD kicks in, because they are being controlled by the Dark Phoenix, partner with Apocalypse and Ultron Sigma. Yes, I know, let it out. I know. I can feel it. I know. It's gonna be okay. Trust me, it's going to be okay. Ryu was getting whooped. I mean, WWE SmackDown from the likes of Phoenix Possessed, Chris, Jill Valentine, Ken, Chun-Li, Strider, Hiryu, Captain America, Black Panther, Iron Man, Mega Man X, Zero, Hawkeye, Spider-Man, Ghost Rider, Venom, Thor, Hulk, Magneto, X-23, Nova, Winter Soldier, Arthur, Taskmaster, Super Skrull, Dante, Virgil, Akuma, Hagar, Zangief, Jetta, Morgan, Sentinel, Upgrade, Captain Marvel, Doctor Strange, Gamora, Rocket Raccoon, Groot, etc. Now you're probably like, Chief, dog, that's the whole main roster. What are you doing?
Let me cook.
Let me cook, man. It's hot in the kitchen. Get out of my kitchen. Get out. Let me cook. Spicy, man. As Ryu was beaten to a pulp and in complete despair, his friends turned against him. He takes a final stand, and as the Dark Phoenix shoots her fire at him, or flames, a crack in reality opens, and he's saved by magic by none other than the Scarlet Witch. See? Let me cook. Dark Phoenix demands they attack, and more heroes appear from the crack and take on the others. This includes, strap in, alright? Miles Morales, Wolverine, Iceman, Cyclops, Jean Grey, separated. Cable, Rogue, Gambit, Colossus, Deadpool, Luke, Jamie, Marissa, Beautiful Joe, Batsu, Edward Falcon, Hayato, Jin Sayatomi, Amingo, Sun Sun, Ruby Heart, Nimrod, Golden Knight Arthur, Sheba, BB Hood, Dimitri Maxiov, Monster Hunter, I don't know who, male or female, Dragon's Dogma character, the fighter, I guess, Amaterasu, Mega Man OX, Mega Man Zero, Leon, Rosemary Winters, Cypher, Murasame. Yeah, I told y'all, let me mother effing cook. Let me cook, y'all. Then what happens next is a full-on battle scene surpassing the intro to NVC3. Like, everyone's going ham. Like, it's like a legit comic book style Marvel beatdown. Everyone's throwing hands, blast, attacks, you see all of it. It's like a goddamn anime fight. E for everyone. Hands are rated E for everyone, dog. Everyone is fighting. Ryu and Cyclops are back to back as they attack the enemies of the other before coming face to face and recreating the iconic NVC2 handshake. There you go. The heroes then all turn to face their possessed comrades in a final clash as the Scarlet Witch's and the Dark Phoenix's powers interact, causing an explosion that shows multiverse timelines and universes in the distance. There's a crack showing green light, and once it breaks fully open, you see none other than the OG boss of Marvel vs. Capcom, Abyss, sitting on Mistrith Death's throne in a brand new armor. He's now slim and looks like a medieval overlord. Think like Dark Souls, pretty much. His left hand holding the skull of Thanos, in his right hand is a unique custom Infinity Gauntlet. He snaps his fingers, and the NVC logo appears. Hey, come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Like, some of y'all are like, oh, that's kind of crazy. Look, come, look, give me my props. This has been in my head since like 2019 for no reason. Like, no one told me, it's just been there. It's just been sitting there. And I think if you saw this in person, you're at Evo, right? And you're like, okay, whatever. You get a teaser, like, what is this? I don't know what this is. Then you get that. Tell me this game is not selling like literally at least 20 million copies. At this point, everyone's like, I don't know. I don't care. I need this mother effing game in my life. I will sell my soul for it. And it looks, Arc System doing the graphics? Hoo-wee. Spicy. The gameplay is where I also want to show my expertise in this field as a guy who's played fighting games since I was a kid. The one thing I wanted most was a way to bring in mainstream to the series again. And how would you do that? It's easy. Combine supers and specials. This was a staple in the original series that it never came back, and I don't know why it did. For the love of God, bring back like combined crossover supers, especially with this game being multiverse. That's gonna make a lot of money. Hear me out. You had Captain America and Ryu trading moves for a super. Like, what the F was going on, dog? Now, imagine that on a bigger scale. Y'all remember Dragon Ball Fighters, of course. The pause phase, and he did a super. Someone came in, you know, it was Gohan and Goku and stuff like that. And you had Trunks. That was pretty spicy. It was pretty cool. It's pretty dope, right? It was fly. But let's do Captain America, Cyclops, and Gambit. I'll make one off the top of my head right now. Let's see. Gambit uses his power to ignite Captain America's shield and throws it. Gambit throws his cards at the opponent, and then they're triggered by Cyclops using his full beam with his visor off, causing a nuclear explosion. Now, in my head, that also just sold about 10 million copies. Like, that could just be like a leak. Like, someone's like, oh, we saw on Twitter and everyone's like playing at you know, Tokyo PAX East, and you're like, huh? A three-way super? Look, I'm telling you, this game would make so much money. Capcom, Marvel would not know. They would not be able to comprehend the money coming in. It would be so much money, they'd be like, oh my goodness, it's so much money. Like, be like, give me my money.
Yeah, just give me my money.
Then there should be a turbo and casual mode, okay? Why? Because y'all gotta stop scaring the hoes. By hoes, I mean people who play fighters for fun. Because like, y'all literally will TOD somebody and they will never play that game again. They will literally get that money back in like 2 hours, 20 minutes straight. It's scary what y'all do to y'all. Y'all out here scaring the hoes. Relax, bro. God dang. Like, people are already stressed out, right? In this economy, I can handle it, but a 9-to-5 person who's struggling to pay rent, they're going to hate fighting games forever, bro. Absolutely not. The turbo mode makes games faster and allows TOD infinite combos, but the casual mode doesn't. It's like, let's have fun with the bros type shit. You feel me? Seems cool enough. All right, seems fun. I mean, fighters are already sort of doing this already, so go ahead and add it, big dog. Go ahead and do it, Capcom. You know, I know you're gonna do it anyway. Then I want to make the move list longer because I want to add more magic to it. I had a list a few years ago, but I don't know, I think I lost it in my files, my old PC, whatever. Then I want to talk about the actual game itself in terms of DLC. So, the DLC will include costumes. And I can already hear some of you guys in the comments right now. Arc System can't do costumes, bro. Well, back in 2018, I would have believed you, and I would have been out of luck. But thanks to a new technology, they can do it faster and at a higher quality pace. But that's a separate video, I'll explain later. It is amazing to say the least, though. There will be multiple costumes as DLC. I would put 3 per character and also add characters themselves. This game should have more characters. Listen to me once again. This game should have more effing characters than any other NBC, period. No hold barred, okay? Unlock the floodgates. It's been a long time coming, and I won't accept excuses. I don't care. If you're wondering how I'd pick characters for DLC, I'd pick them based off of ability. Would they look cool? Would their gameplay actually be fun while attracting current and new players? I even made a list, and yes, a lot of y'all are going to be like, who the F is that? But once again, it's a celebration of classic Marvel and Capcom, okay? I also believe in giving fans what they didn't know they wanted, making the characters have more to offer, and making new ones play so cool that that people can't deny them. That should be a standard in my opinion. I also want to state that this game would have unique designs for each character. They will not look how they normally look. That's okay. All right, giving artists freedom to try something new, especially since it ties into the multiverse story and campaign. Like, obviously, I want Phoenix Obsession and Abyss Obsession costumes for all the characters along with the world costumes. That's just a money machine at that point. You're just printing money for no reason, all right? In conclusion, in Chief's opinion, NBC should be hard rebooted. And now that the MCU and the multiverse is popular once again, it's a way to fix the garbage that was infinite and start from scratch. I'm pretty sure my primary ideas would bring in millions of new and old fans, as well as be the greatest version of the game to date, period. All right. By allowing Arc System's graphics and artistic designs, Disney's free use of any characters regardless of the movies, and Capcom opening the vault and using their legendary IPs instead of isolating them before they lose them, will make this the greatest fighter of all time. Not to mention the unique gameplay, crossover supers, and game modes that install nostalgia. Maybe a jukebox mode, 1v1, 2v2, 3v3 mode, and party mode. I also have some experience because we tried to make a free-to-play MVC game before, being hit with a cease and desist from the powers at B because they were scared of being shown up. And it looked like a AA, AAA game. It had kind of an Arxis style to it. But hey, I'm not mad at Capcom. They have our data, and the new guard's on our side, pretty much. I'm also hoping they go that route, because if they don't follow this, and look, the reason why I'm saying they should do this my way is because there's a rumor going around, right? Another rumor. I know, Chief, it's crazy. Shonen Jump wants to hire Arc System Works for a crossover game of their own. That would be basically NBC again. Like Dragon Ball Fighters Part 2, but with like Goku, Ichigo, Naruto, Luffy, but Arc System style. Marvel will get destroyed again, but it will be this time it will be the nail in the coffin forever. It will be like, okay, this is definitely y'all going crazy. And because they made Dragon Ball Fighters so good by stealing from Marvel, they can just do that again, but do it on a bigger budget, and it's gonna go crazy. So my fear is, let's get Marvel to come back before that happens. All the guys in the comments who were like, we don't need it, it'll beat it. It won't beat it, okay? Dragon Ball FighterZ won game of like fighting game of the year. It's Dragon Ball. Imagine you really go to the Evo and they drop a trailer, right? You see it at your home, you see it on IGN. It's literally Goku, Luffy, Naruto, Ichigo, Deku, One Punch Man, like every character is there and you're just throwing hands. And it's 3v3. Supers, crossover supers. Everything I just said, but it's Shonen Jump. Do you think Marvel can beat that with RE Engine? Be effing for real. They are getting slapped in the mouth. They're dropping meat in Capcom's mouth. I don't want that to happen. I still want MVC to come back, but you need to follow my script, Capcom and Disney. Follow the script I just gave out. Do all this stuff, the game will sell 20 million copies. But that's competition. I'm trying to raise the bar high, trying to jump and get it. Let me stop. Shout out Kendrick though. Look, I'll talk about that Shonen Jump game in the next video. Be blessed, enjoy the rest of your day. Share this video with everyone, let's start the discussion. Chiefs out, adios, wiedersehen, au revoir. I'm 800, I'm part of that. We gotta say, I'm just gonna follow back. We shoot at these niggas, no problem, babe. I'm hitting that trigger.